Hey everyone, welcome to Green Learner. Today I'm going to start a new video series which is about inside Spring Boot. In this series, I'm going to explain everything about Spring Boot, how it works internally. So if you know about the Spring Boot, then it's okay. If you want to get understanding what is this Spring Boot all about, I already have created a playlist about Spring Boot and already covered a lot of videos what it can do. In microservices development, Spring Boot is very much helpful. If you just want to get the understanding, these few starting videos can help you what it can do, right? If you want to know very much about Spring Boot, what it can do in the microservices, this is the big playlist, Microservices with Spring Boot. You can go ahead and check out this playlist, all right? So let me talk about the agenda of this video series that we have. So we are going to talk about the internal architecture. Then we will talk about the starters, auto configurations. Then we will dig deeper into exploring when you start the Spring Boot application, how it starts the things internally, right? Then we are going to talk about the dependency management. We are going to build the custom starter. This is the very much important topic, which these individual topics are going to help me in building custom starters, right? Then we are going to see the failure analyzer. When you're starting your Spring Boot application, there is failure, how you can put your custom message into that. Then we are going to talk about the Spring Boot banners, how we can customize this. Then we are going to talk about the server ports. Then at the end, we are going to cover the Spring versus Spring Boot, right? So we will understand this, and at the last, we will summarize it, what are the differences there, right? So in the meantime, if any new topic is coming, I'll put that also in this agenda, right? So like Tomcat, how it is embedded, and what if you want to use your custom version of embedded Tomcat, how we can use that, right? So this is all the agenda that we are going to cover, right? So this video, we are going to just cover the internal architecture. We will touch upon the few topics and see how it is working, and then we will build on that starter auto configuration and we'll move subsequently, all right? So let's go ahead and get started. Let's talk about the typical Spring login application, right? And imagine that Spring Boot is not in picture, it is not born yet, and we have only Spring framework, right? So how are you going to build that? So this is our login app, right? And here is the user which is coming to login, and here functions you will validate, right? Validate it, and if validation happens, you will show the welcome message, right? This is the typical Spring login app. And if you know the Spring framework, what are the things that you need for this, right? So first of all, you need Spring core jars, right? And then you need view resolvers, right? And then third thing, you need a Tomcat server to run this application, all right? So as this is the MVC application, model view controller, right? And you need the Tomcat server where you can deploy this application where it is running, right? So if I go into detail what you need for this, these are the things that you need, right? So for the libraries, you need a Spring core jar file, you need AOP jars if you want to do some aspect oriented things, right? So you need web jar, you need MVC jar, and you need servlet container. And you need server for deployment. This server can be Tomcat, Jetty, JBoss, anything, right? JDBC. If you, these things coming into picture, if you want to interact with the database, right? So you have to put the JDBC jar, ORM jars, and also if you are managing the transactions, right? So you need the transaction jar also. And for debugging purposes, you need to put the logging also. Logging files, there are log4j is there, right? And slf4j is there, right? So you need to put these jars and create the instances that are over there and put that into context, right? So that when container is starting, it can take into account all those things, right? All these, and apart from this, if you want to any other things, you need to put the libraries of that, and when you have added that library, you have to put that into context, right? In a Spring context, so that when it is starting, it can take into account those jars, right? So these are the things that you need to do manually, right? Apart from this, you also need to take care of the configurations, right? And which port to start when application is running, if there is properties, how to manage those, and profiling. So if you have when you have dev environment, test environment, right, and then prod environment. So your application goes through all these phases, and there are different requirements, right? The different certificate requirements, different passwords for the validation purposes and other things, right? So which changes as the environment changes, right? So how do you manage that? These things were manual, right? So every developer out there who is developing an application has to do all these things, right? Then so you can imagine the headache, right? So most of the time of a developer should spend around the business logic, right? Business logic to build the application, right? But here you see the repetitive things. Every developer out there is spending time in adding these jars and then putting into context and in the container, right? So the team out there in Spring, they came out of this concept, right? So that is Spring Boot. So it should be that you are putting these libraries. These are common for all developers for specific type of application, and these configuration are also common for a specific type of application, right? So what if I can put these libraries into a single jar, and when you add that single jar, all of this gets downloaded automatically, right? And what of these configuration that every developer out there is doing manually, what if I can do it automatically, right? So that we can put some default configuration, and developer out there what he is needed can continue with, and if he wants to change particular thing, he can go ahead and change that. But this is common requirement, and most of the developers going to follow that, right? So this is the thing that they were thinking, and then they come up with the concept of Spring Boot, right? And the main thing that Spring Boot does is all the libraries that you were doing it manually, there comes starters. Spring Boot starters are there. So there are, like, when you want to add the database specific libraries, so they have Spring JDBC starter jar. So when you add that jar, so all the related dependency gets downloaded automatically, because those are configured into that jar, right? So similarly, other specific type application, when you are going to develop the web MVC application, there are Spring Starter Web, right? So which contains all the related jar which is related to Spring Starter Web, right? And similarly, for the configuration part, they come up with the concept of auto configuration, right? So this thing, what they automatically configured the things, right? So that Tomcat you needed for that, they automatically embedded that Tomcat into the starters, right? So and configured that when you start your application, right? So just to show you quick view, let me show you one sample application and how quickly you can get started with this, right? start.spring.io, this is the official website where you can go ahead and create the project very quickly. I am using Gradle as a build project, right? And this is named this GL, and just keep it demo purpose, right? So just I want a REST endpoint. For that, I need this Spring Starter web, right? So I'm generating this project, right? So if I go ahead and open this, let me extract this into this one demo, right? So here it is. So you can see it has given me the structure of the application, right? So all the structure that I needed, typical Spring Boot application, right? So main, Java, sources, and it has created the things for me, right? So this demo application it has given me, right? So I am using IntelliJ IDEA to develop the application. So if I open this in IntelliJ IDEA and show you how quickly I can get started with this. So this is the IntelliJ IDEA where it has opened the project for me, right? So it is downloading the dependency. So if I talk about the build.gradle, so Gradle, it is the like if you know about the Maven, similarly it is the advanced after Maven. So build tool history, and came first, then Maven came first, and then build.gradle is gaining the popularity in the market, right? So if you compare the Maven and Gradle, Gradle is far beyond efficient than Maven, right? In terms of startup and dependency resolution, it is way beyond better than Maven, right? So in future video series, I'm going to also start a build.gradle tutorials where I'll explain everything about it, right? So For now, just focus on this Spring Boot dependency section. I added only one dependency, that is the starter web. All right. So, and test, this starter test gets added automatically when you create the project from that startspring.io website, right? So this is it, and it has, I only have added this dependency, and it has downloaded all the dependency that is needed by this starter web, right? So if I come here, it has downloaded all this dependency, right? So this starter is there, right? So can see. And if I want to run this application, and just I just want to show you how quickly you can get started with starter web application, right? So Tomcat is also embedded, and I want to build an application that is, I just want to create a Hello World application for the simple So we have created this Hello application, right? And that's it. I do not need to configure anything. I can go ahead and start running this application, right? So run demo application, right? So this has embedded the Tomcat for me, and it is building the application. And the main point here is the time of the developer should be focused on the business logic, right? So client requirement that is there, he should focus on that only, right? So Spring Boot has helped a lot in getting that purpose, right? So if you do not framework level things, you do not have to worry much, right? So all the things has been taken care by the team itself, right? So this Spring Boot is started just quickly, and it has embedded the Tomcat. By default, it is running on the port 8080, right? So if I go ahead and hit the endpoint, it is running on port 8080, and name of the endpoint is Hello, right? Hello thing, I got it, right? So it is working properly. So you yourself can see how quickly you can get started as per the requirement, right? You create the application and start this quickly. You don't have to download the Tomcat separately and deploy the application there. It is embedded with the Spring Boot itself, right? So the main point about this series is exploring the things inside the Spring Boot, right? So how it has downloaded all this dependency, where the version of this dependency is managed, right? So you can see, so I added only one dependency, that is here starter web. Even I haven't mentioned the version here, how it is taking that version, right? And where are these dependencies mentioned, right? And how auto configuration part is being taken care. So all of this I am going to explain in this video series one by one, and then we will move ahead and we create our own custom starter, right? So if I want for our own, how we can do that, right? So I'm going to explain that to you also, right? So moving ahead, after developing the application, application monitoring comes into picture, right? So Spring Boot does that by this dependency, Spring Boot Actuator. I already have covered this in detail on this link. You can go ahead and watch this, right? So as explained in the agenda, next video I am going to cover about the starters, right? So how many starters are available there in the library, right? And where are the configuration, where are the other dependencies that are inside there? If I want to know how many jars are mentioned in particular starter, how can I know that? So everything I'm going to explain that in the next video, right? And then we will move to the auto configuration part, right? So in this video series, you're going to get everything about the internals of the Spring Boot, and this is very much important from the interview perspective also. If you're going to interview for the microservices and Spring Boot, this video series is going to help you a lot in cracking that interview, right? So I hope you learned something from this, right? So I'll see you in the next video with these topics, right? So till then, take care. Bye-bye.